You gonna show the picture again?
There we go, yeah.
It's Cinnamon Cooney, the Art Sherpa. And hello again, because what you guys don't know is I went and did the whole intro and was talking to you. And then dear husband in the control booth goes, wait, we're not even live. So I'm Cinnamon Cooney, I'm the Art Sherpa. Tonight we're going to do Van Gogh's Starry Night, a la Doctor Who with the TARDIS in the sky. For those of you that saw that episode, season 5, it's a pretty exciting one. But you know, the TARDIS is at the last part, so if you don't want to put a Time Lord in your Starry Night, you don't have to. Materials, 16 by 20 canvas, pre-gessoed. I like to get the cheap packs from Michaels because that's just easy and cheap for me. I made a hat, which again, I showed you earlier, and I made this really cool, crazy hat just for this, and I got my Van Gogh-ness all on. Paints, I'm going to be painting with pro acrylic paint. It's going to be a mixture of liquitex and golden tonight. I don't have any Matisse out tonight, but basically how that works is you just catch a sale. One going on right now at Jerry's Autorama, 40% off golden. I just heard that from my mom today, so that's sort of big exciting news. Paint colors from whatever paint you're painting tonight. Mars Black, Yellow Ochre, Cad Red Medium, Cad Yellow Medium, Thalo Blue, Dog's Eating Purple, Titanium White. Remember, I like to hide things in the description, like information about stuff that you might need. So that's generally where I put all those links and things and bits about what we're working with.
Now, Cinnamon?
Yes.
Everyone's going on about your hat. They love your hat.
And
the outfit.
I had a moment.
Did you?
I did.
What was your moment?
Well, it started with my little, I really like these little yellow chicken feathers, and
there is some chicken feathers next to it.
It just grew from here, and I just had a blast, and there's the little secret guys in there. Can you see my little secret dragonfly and frog sparkle right there?
How is this going to look under the black lights?
Under the black lights. Soon we'll find, you know what? I really want to know how this is going to look under the black lights, because we could do it under the black light. If I have to make a whole nother hat, I'll test it out. I got my sippy sippy.
You do? And everyone is out here saying hello. There's so many names. I mean, like just a wash of people out saying hello.
I peeked into our virtual green room before we started, and I was really excited about everybody that I saw there. Did a little pull behind the curtain. All right.
So you ready to get started?
I'm so ready to get started. You guys ready to get started? Okay, over on the left-hand side, about my hand width up, or if you're very, very precise, you could get a ruler and say 3 inches, and then almost a little under twice that, I'm going to say like 5.5 inches, maybe 6 inches. On this side, I'm going to make another mark on the right side. I think you can see that there fairly well. And I'm going to draw a hill coming down. Now here's a little trick. You want to try not to clone. You want to try to just slope down. And there you go. See, it just implies that little rolling hill. You don't want to have it just be one straight line. You do want some dips and some stuff in it. Interestingly enough, I'm going to come up. Ooh. I'm going to say almost another 5.5 inches up here and make a little mark. And then 5.5 inches over here, make a little mark. And I'm going to do this sort of like background rolling mountain set.
It appears we have some more Australians with us.
Hey, Australians! That is awesome! Hey!
Taking a quick break for your sip.
So they get to paint in Matisse very easily in Australia. They just have to pay a lot for it. Because for some reason, it's more money in Australia. So I'm going to come up just about an inch above this and follow this with a little parallel line. And I'm just blocking this in. You can adjust this in the paint as you go. This is just so you know kind of where stuff is going to be. And then I'm going to very loosely, in this halfway point between this line and my corner, make a little mark. And I'm going to pre-sketch in my swirl. Now I do that because the swirls are this weird thing that can throw even me or just people in general when you're painting. They get a little tight on you, they can get a little weird on you. So if you pre-sketch them in, you can kind of get a sense of their placement and not feel as stressed. And they're gonna paint out, it just...
Victoria is from Hungary.
Hi, Victoria from Hungary, that's awesome.
Yeah.
So, and I know I'm going to have a little thing over here. So, interestingly enough.
Tucson, Arizona.
Tucson.
I'm just going to pester you with people from back here. I get to do that now.
Yeah. I like it. I like to know where I'm into it. I like to know where everyone's from. And my grandmother lived in Havasu.
I think it's a drinking game because every time you pick up the glass, someone says sippy sippy.
Sippy sippy. Oh, wow. I would love to have a drinking game based on me. That would be so cool. I'm going to get...
You have to show everyone your brushes, though.
I'm going to show. I'm just trying to think what size. I think I'm going to do...
Are you looking for a non-embarrassing brush?
They're all embarrassing. A quarter inch bright. This is just like from a cheap economical dollar and roundy. Just like, this isn't even a specialty brush. And I like to just sort of do a couple things before I lay in my blue too much. Just, we're going to do what's called not an acrylic color gram. We're going to actually do this in an underpainting. So I'm going to make a little circle here about the size of a coin or quarter. Just to know where that is. That's where my moon is going to be. And then over here, just over to the left, I'm going to add a little star shape. I'm going to come up and add a little star shape, you know, because it is Starry Night, right? It is Starry Night.
So, Cinnamon, can you pull that up to the camera and let them see where those marks are really well? There you go. And tilt it maybe a little bit. There you tilt it down that way. That helps a lot.
That's perfect.
Yeah. Just so everyone can see where those marks are, get a good idea.
You know, I like that.
Okay.
I mean, if we're going to be down to two cameras for a minute and no close-up cam, I like that. But we're working on it. I'm going to put another little one kind of coming up off here.
And if it helps, I can pull up real quick. I can pull up here and let everyone see there's where those marks will end up going.
Yeah. But, you know, I mean, again, you do this and you kind of get relaxed about it. And sometimes you'll add some stuff and sometimes you won't. I don't get too many stars over here because I know I got this big cypress bush coming that's going to be in there. And just to remind myself a little bit where it's going to be, I will, with this yellow paint, and interestingly enough, this will not affect the outcome, kind of mark in these swirls and go, dude, I'm going to have some here. So when I'm coming with my blue, I'm like, all right, I know I got that. Now I'm going to put that little brush in water and let it soak like I'm totally not supposed to, and get a 1 inch wide bright. I'm going to take my phthalo blue and my dog's name purple, or my deep purple, whatever it is, and I'm going to make almost an indigo color.
It's a really pretty blue. It matches your hat.
It does. I'm going to come in here. And listen, if your yellow's wet and you get a little green going here, guess what? None of that actually even matters. And I'm just going to paint this in with that blue, because this is our underpainting. This is just, there is a reality in painting where you got to get a first layer in. Nothing else to do but to do that. You have to have so much paint on the canvas.
Victoria asked a really good question of how many Doctor Who fans are here.
Oh, I totally want to know. How many have we got?
We'll have to see. We have a whole lot of them popping up here.
So we have enough where we could say they're Whovians?
Oh, yeah. There's a lot of Whovians here.
But we should explain, because not everybody... I've been shocked to find out not everybody watches Doctor Who.
But they're double Whovians, because you're a very Whoody person.
Ah.
It's a bad pun on a bad pun.
No, that's a good pun. There is no... First of all, no such thing as a bad pun. That doesn't even exist. All puns are good.
I think you've just been in game development too long.
No, I'm sure. I have a complete belief on this. All puns are good. I believe in the pun. It's punrific. So, yeah. So we have Whovians and double Whos, because They love them some owls, and I like that. Who? Okay, so Doctor Who, for those, if you're here going, oh my God, what's this box doing up in my Van Gogh Starry Night that you don't have to paint? For any, this is just at the end. This is your world. You can put it in or not put it in as you see fit. I've seen people put in the Death Star. I've seen people put in the end. So you could put in just the stars and be like, no, Van Gogh did not put in those things. Doctor Who is a BBC show that has lasted, I don't know, like, since black and white TV. John might know the exact number of years. There have been 11 actors portrayed him.
I don't know the exact number of years, but I went out and I made a point of watching the original stuff because I consider myself a Who fan. And so I went back and I watched it, and I have to say that it's very contemporary television. So it was definitely for its time. It's very interesting to watch because it gives a good perspective back into then. But it's definitely, there's been an evolution of who the Doctor is.
Yeah, yeah. Every regeneration. Anyway, backstory is he's a Time Lord from a planet called Gallifrey, and there was a giant time war with this evil species named the Daleks, and he battled them and he won, but in it he had to destroy all the other Time Lords, so he's alone and he travels through the universe, and when he gets old he doesn't die, he just regenerates, and he's got this time ship called the Tardis that got damaged, and so it's stuck as a police box instead of its ability to just sort of hide itself. Maybe she's not even damaged. I'm not sure she's damaged.
She may just be stubborn at this point.
She may just be stubborn at this point. I'm of the theory that she's maybe just being stubborn.
So Victoria was curious if you had ever seen Doctor Who. I think that may have answered it.
Yeah, the episode with Van Gogh actually made me cry.
Yeah, that was a great episode.
I just, for some reason, that just was so super healing and affirming, and it was like they went and they just said thank you to him in a way that we would all feel, because we all have such strong, fabulous feelings about Van Gogh. And here's a man who really suffered. He suffered with mental illness and health issues his entire life, and he had a tumor on his brain. It caused him to see things a little differently, and no one in his own day, talk about not getting validated in your own day, no one in his own day besides his own brother really valued his art. I mean, he was always seen as talented, he was educated, he was nearly married, but she went bananas and then tried to kill herself, and he saved her life, which is sort of crazy when you think how that all played out. And he was very infatuated, like on a fan level, with Gauguin, who may actually be more responsible for the missing ear than anyone else. There's been quite a lot of historical, I don't know, tea spilling, gossiping, that they think maybe it was actually Gauguin who cut his ear in a fight. Because Van Gogh had a psychotic break during one of his visits. But here he is, his mental illness.
Oh.
Yeah?
There's a question that I think needs to be addressed that's okay. Come up. And it's Ivan asked, what is the bunny thing you all have been referring to? and I'm going to take this time to take my hand off the control and sippy sippy myself.
Sippy sippy. So what that is there is a fabulous YouTuber who also lives in Texas. The channel's Graveyard Girl, and her name's Bunny. And she's funny and she's witty. And she tests things that are sold on TV for me, so I can see if they work. As seen on TV. I love it. And she does really good unboxings. And I don't mean like, because you know some of those unboxings are really like, oh good, you went shopping, I'm so happy for you. But she like gets things, I'm like, what is it?
Like the stuff you really want to know about, like yeah. Hair chalk. And
or ballerina shoes.
Yeah, just like the weird stuff as seen on TV. She gets it and like you get the lowdown.
Yeah, I made John watch her too.
I think it's funny. Tell?
I think she's super funny. I think she's super talented. And there's a thing, you know, with your friends in the South where you can be like sippy sippy, and she does that. And every time now when I have a drink, I go in my head, I go sippy sippy. we said it at VidCon and somebody screamed, she said sippy sippy.
So now it's a thing.
So now it is a thing. All right, so that's in. And see, we just sort of block that in. I haven't been careful. You could be careful. It's okay to be careful. Let's see if I can get this at that angle that really, oh, there. I think that shows it.
That looks pretty good.
Yeah. So I've just been careful enough to have a layer of paint on here. I'm sealing the canvas. I'm coating it with color. That will show through as I'm painting. It's all pretty easy. Now you're going to want to wash this out really well or switch brushes to another brush. I'm going to do a half inch angle because I'll be using that a lot in the brush strokes up here. Purple and yellow are contrasting colors, and if they get in it with each other, they make a gorgeous kind of putty gray, which intentionally is wonderful, but if you don't want it, will mess up your painting. So I'm going to take just this yellow and do this psychotic stripe right here, which is a lot of fun for me. Kind of did things in a weird order. Sometimes I do that when I'm doing paintings. I get in a weird process order. They talk about that in art a lot. The process order of your art is so important. I went to art school. I had to listen to that. Actually, no, I had Reverend Tallis. It was a whole nother level.
So there, everyone is talking about the time that we're running right now. That we're running our shows a little later at night.
Yeah.
And you want to talk about why we're doing that?
Okay, actually, we'd love to run them a little earlier, but I have a 10-year-old, a 5-year-old, and a 3-year-old, and the soonest I can negotiate a bedtime with anyone puts me in here at 9. As soon as I can come up with something that they want more than staying up later, we'll meet at a more convenient time. Gotta get my little hat up. It's getting a little dark in there. Can't even see the Sherpa. I'm not really going to talk about myself in third person. That's not happening.
So the kids are not sleeping. Shannon just asked if the kids are currently sleeping, but they are reasonably quietly hanging out in their bedrooms doing artistic things with iPads and devices. So we'll hope that that holds them for the next, you know,
yeah,
45 minutes to an hour.
It could go either way.
So if they wander in, we'll just say hello. And then we'll send
hopefully
them on their way.
They come in. We'll stop them if they've decided to disrobe for sleep. We'll stop them. Margaret will catch them. All right, so down here I'm going to do an interesting thing. Well, I've still got this yellow on my half-inch angle brush, which if you guys paint with me a lot, you know I love this brush. It's my multi-purpose tool of all brushes. I'm going to get a little CAD and a little, y'all, make some light colors here. And down here I'm going to have a little bit of fun kind of creating an abstract space. What I mean by that is I'm very loosely going to be painting with this yellow and orange, creating random shapes and kind of patterns, and that's going to be showing through my grassy hill. See, we're not trying to do a really hard reproduction of Van Gogh's Starry Night. We're trying to have the experience of being in the brushstroke with Van Gogh, right? We're trying to know what it felt like and to be there. And the brush stroke is the fingerprint of the soul.
So someone was asking about our playlist that we have kind of going in the background. This is we purchase a lot of premium music and license that so that we can have it here on the show. And that's what you're hearing running in the background. And we'll see if perhaps somewhere we can get a list of those songs and where you could find them.
Yeah. All right. See this right here? So this is what I want you to think about. Right now, tonight, your painting goal, your painting mission is you're going to be finding your brushstroke. Your brushstroke should not be my brushstroke. The way I get paint up on a canvas, you know, take technique from me, take advice from me, learn some art skills. But I'm not teaching you to paint like me. I'm hoping to help you paint like yourself. Your painting should look like you. Your friend's painting or family member's painting should look like them. It should really be almost like you're looking at an interesting psychological self-portrait.
So we got some interesting questions that are coming in. I'm gonna
okay.
gonna pull your attention over here. So somebody wanted to know where you got your apron at.
Oh, I'm really happy to share that.
I know. I thought you would be.
This is one of my favorite people in the world. I get aprons from her all the time. I buy from her all the time. I'm going to point out this nice accompanying thing she likes to do on her aprons. This is a little tissue holder that matchy-matchies. And it's Anita Boxel at Empty Nest Designs on Etsy. Empty Nest Designs. And I actually have, for a future giveaway that's coming up, a boys and girls version of this apron as part of the giveaway, including everything you will need to have a painting party at home. I'm doing that. Paint, the easels, the brushes, the whole shenanigans, and of course the apron. So, two lucky people.
So it's really funny. Fabric Paper and Beads joined us here on...
Oh, hi!
Well, she was watching on her iPad live and heard us talking about all of the chat interactions. So she's come in and joined us on chat so that she can comment with us.
Oh,
so
I'm really glad.
Us. Yeah.
I have to tell you, we re-kitted the studio. So we're kind of live now when we're doing
committed
these.
To this.
Huh?
We're kind of committed.
Yeah. I'm back to the pal. There you go. You're so good at that.
Pay attention to the camera. Get back. Do your job. Stop drinking that beer. No sippy sippy for you.
No, definitely sippy sippy for the husband who's hanging in at night helping out. Definitely sippy sippy.
Oh.
For sure.
Oh, so Silverback Crafts is in the UK where it's 3:24 in the morning. So someone's committed.
That's a level of commitment, man. That is, thank you. Thank you very much from the bottom of my heart. That is a total level of commitment. I am really into that. I don't know about you, John, but I don't know about you guys. I just like this better. This feels like I really like this, being able to be live and talk to people and answer questions while it's happening.
Yeah, I'm paying attention to some of the comments there because Ashley's been watching for a year with us.
So. A year? Hi. We just did some interesting math, actually, didn't we, John?
I think that was some kind of awestruck math there.
Yeah. We figured out that so far people have watched in total 10 years and 97 days. And it'll change after tonight because we'll have all watched here a video. 10 years worth, a decade.
So Secret wants to make sure that you know that she's here and saying hello. Do the secret dance. You doing the secret dance?
Hey, girl.
I feel like I should put some beats on.
With the hat, it's like even better. And I would like to point out that it's a tribute dance, but it is not an accurate representation of how Secret dances, which is quite good. We Skype sometimes and with Bernadette and Maricha and Secret. And hopefully Claire, when she gets back, we get to Skype sometimes and talk YouTubery stuff because we all have YouTube channels. And so that's how I know the secret dance.
So Laura was asking if I paint. And I'll take a picture of my canvas for tomorrow night's broadcast. And I'll have it ready for when someone asks.
Are we broadcasting tomorrow night?
Well,
I mean, we can. I have art. If anybody wants to, we can.
I don't know. We'll see how people respond.
Okay.
We'll see if they're that interested.
We can do a broadcast tomorrow night. We've got art for it. I think it'll be a tree.
We should at least, yeah. We have some other lights we got to test too.
Oh, that's true. We got to test some lights too. All right. So I'm going to get back. And I'm going to do kind of an interesting thing here. I'm going to get just my purple. And just with my brush, I'm going to divide this sort of in half.
And Bernie wants to let you know, make sure that we know that she's here too. She's making sure we got everybody ratcheted down out here. So
has it been interesting tonight or has it been pretty
very,
chill?
Very chill. Very nice. Everyone's been just lots of love. In our perpetual love machine.
That is very cool. Well, actually, I think that the art community is much better than many of the other communities I've seen where they did live broadcasts. We have for the occasional errant rogue element, we actually do pretty well. I think. Pretty nice group.
We have a great group.
I feel pretty blessed. When talking to other YouTubers at VidCon, I was like, I'm so glad I'm in the arts and crafts sector of YouTube. Even if we don't have our own category yet, I think of us as a category, and I really like everyone in here that watches how-to art and craft creative videos. They're a pretty swell bunch of people.
Yeah. Well, Janine was just pointing
out. Hi, Janine!
She pointed out that she thinks that I must be into this, and I was like, well, I get to come in here every night and heckle my wife in front of all of you, so, I mean, it's not all that bad.
And I can't do nothing about it either.
No, it's live. You're stuck out there. I'm safe back here.
Remember to take the deep breaths. Relax. Remember that it's just art. It's not a big deal. You're just painting. At least on your canvas, once the paint dries, you can make everything okay. Ooh. Sippy sippy to the bunny. I'll tell you what would trip me out is if Bunny ever ended up inside one of these. Would that just freak you out, John? They would be like, awkward! And really awesome. So I've taken some just blue here. And it's kind of nice because you can see how adding purple to the blue changed its tone for the sky versus what we have going right here.
Kathy from Costa Rica just said hello.
Kathy from Costa Rica! Kathy, I need you to message me and tell me what paints you can get easily in Costa Rica, because Shannon Green and I have been talking about doing the most amazing global art project idea, and so I kind of need to know, like, what art materials for sure you can get, like chipboard, cardboard, white glue, whatever it is. Need to know. Totally just conscripted Kathy into a project. She just thought she was showing up for art. And actually, just in general, if you are living away from the U.S., and you can really help me with this, if you're living away from the U.S., let me know what your art supply availability is. Can you get canvases? Can you not get canvases? Can you get acrylic paint? Can you not get acrylic paint? Can you get gouache? Can you get tempera? I mean, is it just cardboard? What do you have to make art projects with? Shannon Green and I were talking the other day about how wonderful it would be to make a series of art projects that were global, that were globally viable for everyone everywhere. And we really like that idea, and she has a channel, Shannon Green, very cool chick. So, and I think a bunch of other people are gonna come in and participate in that. I've been getting really good advice from Bernadette and Secret and Maricha, and I imagine there's gonna be actually a whole group of artists getting involved in that project just because it's awesome.
We've had a question come up here that I missed. I saw it come up the first time around, but couldn't get to it.
Okay, cool.
So I'm going to get it this time. It's what is our favorite craft stores? And this was originally directed towards me, but now is towards the entire group, so I'll make sure I answer it. AutoZone or O'Reilly. Either one of those would probably be my favorite craft store.
Yeah, he's not even kidding. He is not even kidding.
So what about you? Which one's your favorite?
For me?
Yeah. Art Asylum was pretty cool.
Yeah, I really liked Art Asylum. You can check out that video that's on Shannon Green's channel. I thought that was a pretty amazing art supply store. Jerry's Artorama here in Houston. The manager is Daniel Elliott. I really like that store. I like Texas Art Supply. I like Art Supply in Maine. And of course, you know, I go to the lobby where you hobby sometimes, and the closest to me is Michael's, so I end up in there a lot because I just feel like I don't want to get on the freeway or deal with the toll road, so I just go to Michael's. I'm like, I got a 40% off coupon. I'm sure they got something I can buy. So that is my real true crafting experience.
And you're painting the side of your canvas right now, aren't you?
No, I'm not, but you could. If you didn't want to frame this sucker.
Why would you do that? Why would you paint the side of the canvas?
Okay, well, so here's the deal on this. Here's the straight scoop. These are actually still considered. It used to be that they put the staples around the edge here. So you had to pop this in a frame to get a finished look. But then the beautiful wide stretchers started happening with the gallery wrap, and somebody coined that as a way to get it, like, you don't have to frame then. A lot of museum canvases are gallery wrapped. And so then all the canvas companies started doing the staples on the back. So if you paint the edges, you could just say wire your painting and then get it up on the wall and not have to frame it. And that is a perfectly acceptable solution. It's perfectly acceptable to go in and get a frame. Oh, we do 16 by 20s. So actually this is always economical because you can always find 16 by 20 canvases on sale, but it is a good way to manage your framing solutions if you can't frame. And that's why sometimes chipboard is not actually cheaper or canvas board, because you have to frame. You're stuck in that solution. So all in all, if these are like $2.50 a piece or $3 a piece, that's probably one of your cheaper solutions for just putting some artwork up on your wall. Let's dry this sucker because I want it to be dry. All a Muppet up there. I got the Muppet hat on. Oh, I get going with the bangs and then I never get them right again.
So
like once the bangs go off, there's no getting them back. It's like beyond hat hair. It's like on another level. It's like hair revolting against me.
So we utilized the some of you may have caught, we utilized that time there so that we could,
I mean, it's one of the benefits from getting to film so late is I get to have something besides coffee. And so I'm pretty excited about that. All right, we're going to do the Starry Night sky up here. If you need to put out some more paint, put out some more paint. I'm going to mist my paint, keep it a little bit moist because it gets a little dry in the studio for me. I am going to grab my half inch angle brush. That's the brush that I like to use. And I'm going to start working out some stuff on my sky. And so the first thing that I feel like I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a little white and a little yellow together. Very interestingly enough. And I am going to start putting in the basis of what will be my swirls. And so these are going to be thicker on this side and taper thinner as they swirl. Now, one of the places y'all get real hard on yourselves, I have noticed, I've taught a few of these, is the swirls. So this is just a man going through mental illness, having to take a bunch of medication, drinking a bunch of absinthe, having psychotic episodes regularly, trying to paint things as he saw them and felt them, right? Which means there's no correct swirl.
All the swirls are good swirls?
All the swirls are good swirls.
I never met a swirl I didn't like.
You never met it? I also never met a... Boy, you're bad. And some kind of dashing here.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
I'm kind of just doing this sort of dash, dash, dash.
Margaret pointed out I have missed a comment here, a question a couple times, which is, did you make or buy that fantastic hat?
I made it.
How...
I made it. This is, the base hat came from Target, and the embellishments were all from the craft store and my hot glue gun. Got a little out of hand on me, but I had fun.
So, there was a question about framing.
Yes.
And framing cost. And I was saying that it's real hard to quote specific costs around framing, but you had some good ideas on how to get good deals on framing and where to look for them.
Okay, so if you paint your canvases in what's called standard sizes, that'd be like 8x10, 16x20, 11x14, 24x36, 4860, especially in the 16x20, 8x10, 11x14 range, you will find that places everywhere have frames that will fit your canvas. You can buy clips for about $1, and these are these weird little metal clips that will clip your frame in. You don't even have to nail it in, and you can wire it in. You can get a whole thing in a frame. You should be able to do a nice frame work for under $10. Just looking for sales, looking for stuff. If you're not trying to pick crazy moldings, where framing and the Framers Association is going to come for me now. The reason framing is expensive is because they have molding that is $24 an inch or $500, and I'm not exaggerating, an inch, a linear inch. So you have a canvas by this size, you take it to the frame store, even Michael's or even Hobby Lobby, and you try to get any of their custom framing. These moldings can be very pricey, and you're just trying to pick something that goes with your house, and all of a sudden they come back with like a $1,500 bill, and you're having a heart attack right there, and y'all going, wait, I just wanted some wood, some square wood for my painting. And so, but because we're painting 16x20, you know, that's a standard size, and then you could go to, say, Michael's or Hobby Lobby or the thrift store and find a frame you like and get it in for $10, and it's just such a world of difference.
So I'm gonna
hopefully that answers that.
I think that does.
So I'm just kind of trying to be like a little bit strokey, so the basis of this really fits into this is what I'm doing. I'm gonna rinse this out. I may change out my water cup here.
While you're doing that, I'm gonna go back through some of these comments, and I'm gonna butcher some names, I'm sure.
Okay.
So Jocelyn says hello from San Mateo,
hi,
California. And she said, please tell Cinnamon that she is an inspiration to the newbies like herself. And thank you. She's done two paintings already and really loves everything you're doing here on YouTube.
Thank you. Two paintings. Awesome. That is awesome. Have you shared them on the Facebook page? So I've seen them.
And there's been a slew of great comments from Brittany and Touchdown and Ashley, and I wasn't sure who said it, but I'm not sure if it was something that somebody said out here or if it spawned my thoughts. But we needed instructables on how to make a Sherpa hat.
Oh, I would be very happy to do instructables, Periscope, all kinds of things on how to make a Sherpa hat. Might even make a YouTube video on how to make a Sherpa hat. It's fun to make a Sherpa hat. I don't knit though. None of the knit ones are mine. I'm not a hooker.
I'm not a hooker. No, you're more of a hot gluer.
I'm a hot gluer. See, that was a knitting joke. I just learned that this year.
Did you?
Yes, that I'm not a hooker. I'm a hot gluer.
Are you?
That's a knitting joke. I'm not even being funny.
Okay, I'm gonna wait for the. I'm gonna let the comments determine whether that was a joke or whether that was.
It is. That's a knitting. That's crochet and knitting.
I'm not sure if you're just I've punishing taken a
little,
us with that.
Okay, hold on. I've taken a little of my yellow over to my blue. Still gotta do this painting. I'm coming over here, and I've got this, and I'm going to get a scotch of white, and I'm going to create not a sky blue, it's deeper than that, but maybe like a blue you might see at dawn. And here, this is very important. So I'm going to come, and I'm going to go around my objects, and I'm going to make little dashes happening around my object. Imagine how I get this is that I imagine that the stars are stones that have dropped into a pond of water. And the dashes are the radiating circles, the concentric circles that come out from it. When I get near here, I'll fall along here. You're just imagining all these shapes are making ripples in the water. And here is a very important space. I used to see this all the time where somebody would be a very type A person and they would make perfect little tiny dashes around, and their friend would be like a free-spirited bohemian person, and they'd be making these just expressive brushstrokes, and both of them felt their brushstrokes were no good, and that the other one had a much better vision of it. And what this is this is where your artist heart starts to talk back to you, is in this experience when you're figuring out your stroke. This is what you're doing. Now I'm gonna come in here, I'm gonna make some strokes inside here, shaping out my swirls. And this is about layers, guys. This is gonna have a hot mess look for a little bit. Don't panic. Just like the sunflowers, it will come together. All right.
So do you have a preference on paint? And can you talk about the palette paper that you're using there?
So I got this at Michael's. This is, Strathmore palette paper for acrylic. It's not a wax paper, but it's like a wax paper, and it works for acrylic and oils. And it's cheap, like super cheap.
And you could probably find something like that on Amazon if you had
you
a
could,
hard time.
Yeah, you're just looking, if you look for a palette paper for acrylic, a whole bunch of stuff will pull up, expensive options, cheap options. I just use whatever's cheap. I haven't ever had a need to use an expensive option in palette paper. And I'm not together enough to go wash my palette after every time. I have seen people do some very clever stuff with like acetate and saran wrap and stuff, but I'm just like, I just want to crumple it up and throw it away. I'm not saving the environment, apparently. So see me just coming along with these brush strokes. I'm going to show this to you guys.
It's really beautiful. I like the broken up brush strokes there.
Yeah, I tend to definitely be on the relaxed, groovalicious side of the brush stroke. This, by the way, if you can afford it, if you can do it on a big giant canvas, looks amazing.
I'm going to go back over to the palette, because one of the things I was noticing here mm-hmm. is that you're mixing up your paint, not getting just like a pure color, but you're kind of like getting all these different, you know.
Yeah. I try, and one of the things that artists that have worked a long time will do is they will not overmix their paint. We have good paint management, which means I never scoop from the center because that'll waste all my paint. I always work from these weird little outside edges here. And, you know, I gotta carry it, it moves around, and it's all about sort of managing this. And the other thing is that it's streaky because I'm trying to not create totally uniform Home Depot swaths of paint.
They call it painterly?
Painterly. That is how artists like to say, artists be messy. We have a lot of terminology that sounds real frou-frou, but really it just means artists be messy. We're painterly. If you're a very messy, expressive artist, you're painterly. And if you're a very architectural, considered artist, you're tight. So it's just a lot of these terms are just ways for people to talk about paintings without the artist there. So see, we've got that sort of mid-tone there.
Yeah, why don't you go ahead and pull that up here? People like, you can pull it up to the camera. We're going to let them see. Yeah, tilt that back a little. There you go.
What is this cable? You know what? You didn't even notice this cable was like all hanging in.
It was fine until you touched it.
Okay.
See?
All right.
No one use your DVR to prove me wrong.
So that's just, it's super relaxing. I'm telling you what, this sky, you can be in a real rough spot, just stuff going on in your life where you're really freaked out and tense, and this sky will help you come back to okay. It is just like meditating. It's very nice. I'm going to now make a turquoise, which is green and blue. More of a blue-green than a green, and I'm going to add white to it. All right, and I'm going to start adding some of these dashes around, just around the stars.
You don't have a preference on paint?
I do. Well, I like professional paint, so the brands that I always buy are Liquitex, Matisse, and Golden. I like Golden's mixing white quite a lot over the other whites, and I like Golden's zinc white. Not Golden's mixing white. Golden's titanium white. Liquitex is mixing white. Golden zinc. Golden has a really good yellow ochre, but it's translucent, so it didn't do well for me on my paint test, which was really weird. You know, honestly, I'll just go with any paint company that gives me enough pigment and good polymer. You know?
Yeah.
There's no standardization in the industry, so it's almost like a surprise sometimes when you open these tubes of paint what you get. And I'm doing these dashes around the stars, just dashing around. So, Matisse I like an awful lot if you can get it at a good price.
Emmy was asking if you decorate the house with your paintings. And I was going to say, no, I decorate the house with your paintings.
Yeah, I tend to be like, I want to sell them all. And John's like, let's keep them.
I have a hard time letting them go.
But they're a hoard now.
It's a collection.
It's a hoard.
See, there's in art, it's a collection when you have a whole bunch of paintings that you won't let go of. It's everywhere else where a pile of comic books that you love dearly is a hoard.
I don't know.
Or those car parts that you just can't let go of. That's call that a hoard, too. It's art, but, you know.
I think, sweetie, that really is a hoard. That's a lot of car parts.
Sophia says hello. I just looked over, and Sophia Porter was there saying, please don't send me this
hello. Hi! How you doing, sweetie?
Well, thank you, Ashley. You've made our day.
What did Ashley say?
She said that we made her day.
Well, Ashley, he's right. You did. That makes our day.
I don't know what else was going on to that.
We're not really cooking on this one, are we? Kind of going slower today.
No, we're doing pretty good. We're doing pretty good. Some folks like when you take your time and talk. And
I bet the people don't when they're watching it back. They're like, oh my God. You know what's so nice when you watch it back is you can fast forward me. People are like, you take too long, you talk too much, just fast forward. There's a button for that.
So how do you keep your hand from getting in the paint when you do that? You don't have a bridge or anything.
Well, the paint's all real wet right now. And okay, so the correct way to hold a brush is I hold it with a tripod loose grip. I let my fingers touch the ferrule right here, the metal part. I see this all the time where people paint from back here. I'm a little tighter than that, so I need a better grip. And I try to keep it from my shoulder so my arm doesn't get tired.
Yeah, I couldn't say specifically, but I remember you talking about there's like, you paint from the shoulder, mm-hmm. Is that right? So that you don't.
Yeah, I work from my shoulder. This shoulder is crazy out of shape.
Can't That's the do microphone anything. You Can't keep smacking. Dough.
This shoulder is like Popeye. I have but one good shoulder. But I do have one really fit shoulder. Okay, so now I'm going to make a very light blue with just my phthalo and my white. It doesn't take very much phthalo to like mess with your white. You can add a little purple to it if you want to. I'm going to go back again. And this is just, this whole thing really is about the layers. These paintings come together in the layers of paint.
And it's a good time to remind people to take a breath and remember that this comes together.
Yeah, you know what? I always tell people perfection is in completion. The only thing you need to do, especially when you're first starting with painting, is just finish. Just finish. And really, really to my little brushes, to people 15 and under, guys, just hang in there. Don't start to draw something, recognize it's wrong, crumple it up and throw it away. The biggest art growth you'll have is if you push through that experience and finish the drawing or finish the painting. That's actually when your brain hooks up the little neurons that help you with those things like perspective or remembering angles and shading and shapes of things. Just a weird little thing people don't know. It's in the finishing of something, especially if it's challenging, that you have your biggest art growth.
Yeah, and this is your painting.
Yep. Yeah, we're not turning it in for gray. This is just art. It bothers my husband when I say this, but I mean, it's the truth. Poop in a can sold from Sotheby's for $200,000. After that, we can pretty much all relax about our art.
Yeah.
Just, I know it's not your favorite, but...
No, I mean, it's validated itself.
The poop in the can validated itself?
I guess.
No, I think somebody just bought poop in a can, sweetheart. I respect the Met and the Sorbonne and all that, but somebody just bought poop in a can. That was just a really good con job.
This is a really base humor day at the office.
I'm just saying it happened. We all need to acknowledge that it happened. For reasons I don't know why. We all need to acknowledge.
So I'm going to scroll up here. There's a question about your brushstroke.
Yeah?
Ashley asks.
Hey, Ashley.
So is she picking up her brush when she makes those strokes or just pushing hard and soft to make them dash around the yellow?
So okay, so what I'm doing, if I can get it on the palette cam,
okay,
is I've got a pretty light pressure, and sometimes I'm hitting an angle, so I'll switch. I'll either start with the short bristles or the long bristles, and I'm just making these little dashes. Pressure is pretty soft. It's not dry brushing soft, but it's certainly not hard like that. If I went hard, I would go like that, and if I was light, I'd be like this.
And having that streaky paint makes it look even nice.
I am a fan of the streaky paint. And as a lot of painters. Like a lot of painters that are quite well loved are streaky painters. So I'm going to start adding this blue to break up my swirls. Which eventually are going to go white. But I want all these colors in them. If you find that you're just working and working and painting and you're just trying to do anything and you're not getting any result, you don't have enough water or paint on the brush. I'm not messing with you. That is actually what's happening. So just coming up here, starting to lay in the bounty of the swirls, which is really fun to do. The swirls are very freeing. Very freeing. And again, if you're very neat and tidy and you're going, oh, I'm not loose and expressive. Dude, don't worry about it. That is just one way to paint. You know, just not stress out about it. And if you are ever in a place where somebody's making you feel stressed about how you paint, they're an idiot.
Tell it like it is.
It really is what it is. Every time I'm somewhere where somebody is super pretentious and they just know everything there is to know and they get really up in your face about what it is, I listen to what they say, and whatever they're highly critical about is where they're incredibly weak in their painting. Just to a person. Really talented people who are really centered in their artwork generally do not come up and dump on you. Interesting thing. Just saying. One of the nicest artists I ever met in my life, Brian Froud, created all of the design for all of Henson, the
Dark
look
Crystal.
For Lord of the Rings.
Dark Crystal?
Dark Crystal. Man was a complete genius. Sweetie pie, so nice to other artists, no matter their skill levels. Just saying. The more pretentious they are, the
But here, we believe that everybody has the right to paint.
Everybody does have the right to paint. It's literally something everybody has, the right to paint. Now I'm going to come in with some white. Just some white. And I might have a little blue on it. I'm not going to worry about it. It's a little messy. And I'm going to just add a little more into these swirls and kind of work them out. Get a little painterly, a little impasto with it. Thick with the paint and having some fun.
So there's some questions about our live production schedule.
Oh, I have no idea.
We don't know is part of the answer. We're working some things out. Cinnamon's going to be experimenting the next week with some Periscope as well.
And some blacklight painting designs.
And some blacklight painting designs. And then we're going to resume on in about a week.
Between the 17th through starting the 17th. But there will be some very important announcements this week. Very important announcements.
Yes, on your videos.
Oh, and actually, I think I have to. I think what I'm doing is I've got to get a film up of the collaboration I'm doing with Ayla.
Yep. Camera's the other way, though. I know I'm back here. So, hi.
Hi.
Oh, that's out. See, now I have to switch the camera over to so you can say hi. I was looking at the palette. See, I have like four views of her.
I want more cameras back. I want my up-close camera.
We need
See
your
how that's
camera.
Just coming in? I mean, it's all of a sudden it just, dude, it looks like it. Just boom, out of the blue. It's there. So chill. You can't believe how chill this painting is. I always like to see when people are just like, they'll tell me at the beginning of class, like, how every other person in their family had art talent. And I'm doing almost white here going around my stars. Everyone else in the family had art talent. They had none. And then they discover they were wrong. That's my favorite thing.
So Emmy was asking us if we
hi
were going...
Emmy.
Hi. So she was asking if we were going to have an after-event Q&A painting evening party with a Sherpa.
So we're talking about that. What we want to start to do, and I don't know if we're going to get pulled off this week, Emmy, but what we want to do is after... the painting party, we want to have an after party in Google Plus in the Hangouts.
And
where we just all finish whatever's going on, our tea, our cocoa, our riscotto, and whatever we've got going on, and just chat and talk art and just be social.
And we're thinking we're gonna try to shoot to do this three times a week.
The live broadcast, if everyone can tolerate it, we're gonna try to do them three times a week.
Three times a week.
One of them will be the blacklight party.
So
once a
so
week.
So you're saying we're going to have a weekly blacklight painting party in the studio?
Yeah. That's why I'm like, I got to design all next week. That's why I'm like, I got to design next week. A weekly blacklight painting party in the studio.
I know that.
Okay. Are you being funny?
No, apparently not.
Sure, so bad. All right, I'm going to take some yellow ochre, sometimes called yellow oxide.
I'll keep my day job. Wait, this is my day job now.
So these are all heavy-bodied paints. When they all go flat and look like syrup, those are soft-bodied paints. And that's a lot of what you see in those craft bottles. Impact your results a little bit in how they perform. And also how easy they are to put on these little palettes. So I'm coming around just my stars with this yellow ochre. Coming around just my stars, and I will do the swirls, but I don't get it deep into the sky. I don't want to go deep with this. I don't want to go deep. I don't want to go deep at all. I mean, so what's funny is, like, you know, when I'm alone in the studio, I can be like, you're so funny, Cinnamon. But like, now I have confirmation whether I am or I'm not. I'm going to take a little of this yellow ochre, and I'd like to put a little into my wind. Not a lot. I'm going to keep these strokes fairly open and separated out. You
good
may
night,
go
Emmy.
Put some white in. What?
Emmy's having to go, and she said good night. She has
good
to
night,
go
Emmy. Thank you for coming by. Everybody go check out Emmy the Mastermind's channel. She's a very good crafting channel. Hey, Emmy.
And I have to say hello to the official panda from the Netherlands. And
kid, hi! How are you? Hi! I talked to official panda. I got to do a panda painting in here. I've been talking to him forever and ever and ever. He just won the lady scholarship. He just won my mom's art scholarship.
Oh, cool.
I don't know if anybody knows that, but he did. He won it.
They didn't know that. I just have a friend who lives out there. So.
And then, oh yeah, I miss him. Okay, so I'm going to do a little arc stroke, and I just want you guys to be with me. This is sort of, it's a round stroke. I'm going to try to get really up on this.
Yep, you can come in.
See how I'm arcing that up? Like an eyelash or something, I suppose. Or a big open S. But they're not straight strokes. They're an arched stroke. Was that pretty clear, John?
Yeah, I think so.
This is a nice foundational stroke later for when you're doing grass or windswept planes. But here we're just going to be relaxed about it, not worry about it too much. Did Piet get to say hi?
I think so. I, It's tough because I have to watch.
You know what? And I've only been saying his name to myself. And if I'm saying your name wrong, sweetie, I'm American. I'm sorry.
Is Piet the panda?
Yeah, official panda.
Oh, yes, he did. He came in and said, hi, Sherpa.
Okay.
So that's.
But I'm assuming that. All right. So we've got that yellow ochre right there. Now I want to make some orange. And orange is a real fun thing to put in the sky. Is it historically accurate? No, it is not. But you know what? Cadmium orange did not exist then, and Van Gogh used to buy his paint from pirates. Things people may not know.
So that means we get to use cadmium orange now?
Yeah, he would support me. I believe that's true.
Okay.
So I'm going to put dashes of the cadmium in the sky because orange and blue are contrast and look very pretty together. I have seen people do pink and purple with a lot of success as well. This is the radiating light coming out.
Official Panda says his name is pronounced Pete.
Pete! Thank you! I've been saying it wrong, and if I mess with my mom, I'm sorry.
So now we know.
Now we know.
And knowing is half the battle.
And knowing is
I broke my wife.
Oh my god. Oh my god, I wish so bad we had the graphic.
Throw up the G.I. Joe graphic.
He's like, how do you know we don't?
Oh, for tomorrow night.
Go ahead and put a little of this orange. Go ahead and put a little of this orange up in your little wind. Just not a lot, just a little bit. And we're going to come back with some strong white there and really like finish it out. But these little colors shining through make a difference.
Yes. Now, I wanted to say thank you to our moderators tonight who have opted, instead of painting along with us, Secret and Bernie.
So their channels are Secret Soda, Auntie Bernie, and the Junkin' Data Girl. They are other YouTubers that I know through that awesome YouTube artist collaboration. I know like 300 other YouTubers now that do art and crafts because of that art collaboration. And you're going to be hearing about them, and we're going to be talking about them because we're all friends. So now you guys can just go around to all your favorite channels and talk about us to each other because we're all friends. And if somebody's not like, it's not cool, you'll be like, go get in the friend club because they're all hanging out, being YouTubers together now. I've got some just yellow, and I'm putting it out, breaking up this line into my sky. This is my new solution when I don't have my up-close cam. See, I'm just trying to define the stars so that it's radiating light coming out.
You're psyching me out. I keep going to the palette cam.
Well, I'm about to put some paint on that. Does it help if I tell you first?
No.
I'm really loving this. I'm like getting to feel like I'm spending time with you and my friends, and it's really fun.
It's funny. So the Junking Data Girl doesn't think
Maricha.
She doesn't think I could pronounce her name, and I just did. It's the Junking Data Girl. It's very easy to pronounce.
Well, I did used to say Marika. I haven't, you know. Yeah, it's a thing with me. I don't know what to say. It's a thing. We all know it's a thing. I'm working on it. Work in progress. Work in progress. So I like that. Now, remember, if you ever take your sky too yellow or too something and you don't like it, just let it dry and you can put the blue back. You can put anything back. So I'm going to rinse this out. Rinse. I'm going to get right back into my white, and I'm going to even white out even more, but see, then all those layers of paint are coming through. Painting is about layers. I'm going to work my little swirls, just define them again, but now the orange and things are peeking out, and this is the secret, not the secret soda. What the secret?
What about Monet's water lilies?
So this which I should have said at the beginning, but I got my head all befuddled. But you'll see it in the archive when she does it. This is a collaboration with my mom, Ginger Cook. This is where you want a Van Gogh. And mom at some point is going to come back and she's going to answer my Van Gogh with her own Van Gogh. In the talking about what we were going to do about this, we also came up with Manic for Monet. And so if you're into Monet, probably next month mom and I will do that one.
So there's some Monet paintings that could come.
Yeah, I think I'm going to do the umbrella, the umbrella at the beach, the girl on the umbrella at the beach, and I'm going to have mom do the lilies because she's so into that.
Yeah.
And I really like the girl with the umbrella.
Yeah.
And I don't know what Van Gogh painting mom's going to paint. I'm not sure.
You know, after that's all over, I would have to say that those lilies could make a great blacklight painting.
Yeah, I have complete license to do them for the blacklight painting party. Blacklight party in the studio! I don't know why that keeps happening. So can you guys see that? Okay. I wonder if it will do...
You can get real close to it. It's on. I've got the... Yeah, keep going. Keep going. Go right up there. Yeah, they can see it. It's good.
See all the texture and everything in
actually,
that?
Actually, the texture on that one in the upper right-hand corner, you can really see it there, how much texture there is on the paint sticking up.
Yeah. So that's fun and exciting for me. Let's see if I can really get that up there. Now it's fun.
Now you're just going to see if you can get it to autofocus.
Yeah, I'm pretty much... Yeah, all right. I might be doing that. That might actually be happening. So I've got some white. And where I did the yellow ochre, I'm going to come up here and come back with that stroke again. This was supposed to be an abstract-y cloud bank, I think, originally. And I don't mind if a little of the turquoise or a little color gets on my brush and then with the white, and sometimes I'll load it so it has a little bit because I like a little of it in there, in that. I'm just doing that, just relaxing. I love when you guys go by the Facebook page and share with me what you did. Like, it really tripped me out to see peacocks, Bernadette and Maricha share their peacocks with me, like, right after. And then Jaya got in there and remember she shared the girl walking in the rain. It was like her first painting.
Yep.
That was crazy cool.
We should ask everyone to go out there to comment, like, and subscribe.
Oh yeah, that's good for us.
Lots of thumbs up. Those help.
It really does, sadly.
Was it a little sippy sippy time?
Sippy sippy time. Maybe pop another bottle time.
Is it time for me to come circling around there?
It couldn't hurt.
All right, I'll see what I can do here. Let's get some music.
It's getting to be all gaspy.
We're gonna turn a little music on in the background. I'll come up here.
Is it dance party time?
We keep a little background track going.
I can't hear it, so this makes me crazy.
We need to get a studio monitor. Is what we need.
Hold Somebody on. Who like came in not on the live thing is like, is that girl dance? I get a lot of those comments. You dance and talk too much. In the singing, I don't like it. Like, yeah, no more dancing and singing. You have a plan here? Oh, it's a sippy sippy plan. Who else thinks that Maymay needs to like make me a drink? For the five people that know who Maymay is, Maymay Helms, you deserve a drink. She does a funny drinking show. I'm just saying, she should do that. Actually, I have a friend, Dell, that does that show, too. It's pretty cool. All right. What? Yeah, could you also get me some fresh water? Am I still attached? I'm leashed. If I wander off, I fall down. Okay. I've had this thing take me off my feet.
All right, I'm back.
Completely. But is the sound that seems to be working for the live where I don't seem like a Godzilla subbed movie?
I think you sound okay.
Yeah, no, I'm saying, but before we did the leash, we had that one day where I was like about 2 seconds behind my
actor. Yes, but that wasn't the camera's fault. That was a delay in there. So you're trying to psych me out with the camera? I'll just put this up and then be done with you.
Right. Enough of that. We will be having none of that. Don't compare paintings that have happened before to paintings we are doing now. All right. So I'm going to pull some purple out. I may have pulled too much water into it. Pull some purple out. I feel like I want to add a little cad red to it. Just a scotch. And then I'm going to grab some white. And I'm going to come top down and I'm going to make this little arching brush stroke. Now I'm going to blend it into the blue. There's a plan for this. But it's like a zippering that's going to happen. I cannot wait till you guys start posting these on your social media and everyone's like, oh my god, you're such a good painter. You should like totally quit your job. Actually, I've got a lot of YouTubers who are painters on with me tonight. Worth a lot. They've done it already. They've yep. already made that leap. Who all with us tonight has a YouTube channel? Shout out the name of your channel.
We should definitely have some channel shout outs tonight.
We should have some channel shout outs. It's channel shout out time.
All of our moderators have channels. For
all
sure.
of our moderators, actually, because I know them. They deal with our YouTube group, which is the Creative Art Collaboration.
Yeah, I've seen some other people here who I know who have channels that I just recognize as they come through. Yeah. And I'm betting Touchdown Inflatables has a channel that probably has to do with inflatables.
I would hope so.
I don't know. I'm going to have to go check it out now. I'm curious.
See, yeah. Shout out your channel. If you have a channel, go ahead and put that in there. That is okay today. Not weird. We're so isolated on YouTube, aren't we? We're not acknowledged that we're all in it together.
You can see, when you pull it up like that, you can really see that painterly effect that I like so much. Although it's also cute because you can see the feathers in your hair, in your face. Yep.
Now I'm going to come over and get some blue. And I haven't even rinsed out my brush. And I'm going to get some white. And I'm going to come up with brush strokes that zip up into the purple. Are we getting any channel shout outs? Is
we
anyone doing
are.
Any channel?
Yeah, cool. there's a bunch of them. And I think Auntie Bernie said that if post up some links so we can go from there and check them out.
Yeah, go ahead and do that. It's okay.
Yeah, please post up your link so, you know.
If YouTube grabs you and flags you, I'll uncheck you. I'll go in and catch it and make sure you're not flagged.
Don't spam us, but we want to know who you are.
Yeah, no. If you, I'll know you. I will. I know spammer when I say spammer. But if you're just a genuine, honest to God content creator on YouTube, artist, creative visionary human being on YouTube who makes videos, I will absolutely let it. I will make sure it doesn't get flagged. Work together as a team and help each other out. So see how that's zipping.
I was wrong. Touchdown Inflatables doesn't make inflatables. Doesn't have inflatable videos. But does
what do they have? Is it good or is it horrible?
A fan.
Huh?
Just a fellow community member who has come on to paint with us.
Okay. All right. Awesome. I would have thought that too, though. I would have been like, for sure.
So it appears that I have to be able to turn on links so people can do that. So I apologize if I am the moderator in charge that can or cannot do this. This is like our third broadcast.
Yeah.
So we're still figuring it out.
We'll try to do that, though, in future where people can do channel shout outs and future broadcasts. Cause
yeah, we want you guys to share.
Share. Isn't that looking gorgeous?
Pull it up closer. Pull it up. That's really good right there. You can really see that. Yeah. You can see how some of those strokes picked up white and blue and purple all in the same stroke. That's really nice.
And how up close it's a total hot mess. Because that's how that works. That is totally how that works. Up close, it is a complete and utter hot mess. Now, down here in the grass, I'm going to do some interesting stuff. I'm going to take some phthalo blue. and yellow ochre. And I'm going to make this interesting sort of army forest green. And I'm going to come here and I'm going to make very similar brush strokes. And you may need to add some fluid, some water, to get the result that you're looking for. And what's going to happen is the yellow and the orange is going to show through and create like this interesting little glow. And the stroke that I've kind of been doing all up here sort of comes down here. This, for a long time, was the number one reproduction painting image in the world for about 3-4 years, I think, is what Art Business News said. I don't know what it is now. I think it's that cool Russian artist that does the palette knife painting is now the reigning king of that. But for a while it was Van Gogh.
Yeah. So we have lots of people giving us thumbs up out there. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you for the thumbs.
They do help. Thank you.
The thumbs stick with us even after we go back up live.
Yep, you Cinnamon just unplugged herself. I'm gonna turn that down so when she plugs in it doesn't. Alright, sort of. Okay, now I'm gonna turn her back up. You there? Okay. It just goes puck.
If I step on it, it goes. Which is why I think it also because I took myself down a couple times on our first videos, right?
What's that? I'm actually kind of a little bit in awe out here. We have some people going to bat. I think we have a bunch of likes happening out here. So thank you, everyone.
Thank you for the likes. Yeah, whenever you're watching someone's live broadcast, those likes are what makes one of the big differences for them in the YouTube system. So if you think of it, it's like hearts on Periscope. It makes a difference. I don't know what all these people are always trying to come up with, making just the process of just trying to make a video harder. You need more likes and comments, or we show you to no one, anywhere, ever.
But it's sippy sippy time.
Oh, again. Wow, that might be a double sippy sippy time, is what it might be. It might be two sippy. This is like, if you live in
the
Texas,
hat's so cute.
This is a tip to the Sunday hat. I just might wear this out.
We're a hat family.
Yeah, we are a hat family.
I have hats on all the time. You have hats on.
My husband has, like, I have a pretty good hat collection. He has the serious hat collection.
You have the serious hat collection. I have, like, four hats.
But you have Gorin Brothers hats.
They're just felt hats.
They're pretty nice hats. All right, I'm going to grab some blue here. And I'm going to add some blue into this here.
So someone was asking if we can put the finished painting up in the corner. And I probably could do something like that tomorrow night and have that so that I can pull it up. Right now.
We can see how close to a copy machine I am, because things migrate on me too.
Yeah. Well, it's just, I think she's asking just to have it as a reference.
No, yeah, it's a good idea. And, I put these on Pinterest, guys. I put these on Pinterest.
Yeah, and, but we have our,
So if you need to download them, you can download them.
But we can also pull over to, and I can do this real quick.
I'll pull over to camera 4. I'm just putting this here.
So that we can show what the original looks like. Just so that you can have that for a minute. Go back over here.
Or the one I did that one day when I was like, I'm going to add a TARDIS to Starry Night because I really like that episode of Doctor Who.
Who doesn't? Everyone here does. They've all just...
I went through a period where I was like putting the Enterprise in paintings and putting the Death Star in paintings. Do you remember that?
Yep.
I don't know what was going on with me. I was like, just couldn't stop myself.
We need to see some more Kraken.
More crafting?
More Kraken.
Kraken! Jason Bowen does the Kraken. He is not a friend. He does not know me. Clive is trying to get him to come join our creative arts group. Oh, everyone run over, like, after, run over to Jace's thing and say, join the CAC! Let's freak him out!
So tomorrow, we have a lot of questions about our stream tomorrow. Okay. And I think that we're going to try to do same bat time, same bat channel.
Well, so we could do an earlier in the day one.
Oh, tomorrow's Saturday.
That's right. So after the kids go to swimming, we could do an earlier in the day one. We could do one pretty easily around, say, 3?
Rather than committing to a time right now, let's say we're going to put a time up tomorrow morning.
On Facebook.
On Facebook and on our YouTube page.
Yeah, we'll figure it out.
And then we'll have some information about that.
So this is looking pretty darn good.
Really good.
Try to get it up there without... See, I'm hitting cables is what my problem is.
Now, I noticed that some of your brush strokes break up there as well. They're not even.
No. You mean like where the canvas is showing through?
Yeah, so it sort of shows sort of that textural canvasy bit through.
Yeah, yeah. If you're not going to sit there and do it on canvas board, on super sanded gesso where it's all smooth, which is what you should do if you're ever painting a portrait. If you're painting canvas, let that happen.
Yeah, it looks really good.
Oh, let's do the sippy sippy to Bunny! Sippy sippy!
So are we staying the course and going with the TARDIS, or are you going off course and adding like the Death Star?
No, I'm doing the TARDIS. It's a promise. Right. It's a promise I'm going to keep. Let's try.
I'm going to turn that down.
Party.
Yep, this is all happening live.
Right now, anything could happen.
Yeah.
Aliens could abduct me and it would be on camera. Well, that would go viral.
Oh yeah, you should definitely tune in April 1st. There will be a show.
There will be a show.
Many. We'll probably be broadcasting most of that day.
All right, so we're going to do an interesting thing. We're going to put in our cypress tree. We're going to do it over here in the left-hand corner. I'm going to start it almost to the bottom. And what I'll say is the first basis of this, when I come up, what I like to think of is like a drop or a teardrop. And I'm taking a little white and a little bit of yellow. And this will be really important if you're painting a craft paint or a non-pro paint, guys. Because it won't give you coverage, is you're going to need to add white. You're going to need to add white to your paint to get any coverage. Or you will be doing 3 to 4 coats just to get coverage.
So there's some comments in the channel that we rate higher than Ancient Aliens, which is... You know,
how do we rate higher than Ancient Aliens?
I thought that was pretty good, too. They're like they would rather be watching us than Ancient Aliens. And I was like, well... That's pretty cool.
It's awesome. Really? But Mermaids, that was a pretty good documentary.
Mermaids was a good one. And that had Honey. She just was like, for my months. Daughter
is like,
but
it's
Santa's
true.
Real, right? And so are Mermaids. It was on the Sci-Fi Channel.
No talking her out of that one. And actually, I think we should all believe in mermaids. I mean, that's something we should believe in, is something that's true. You should never get at a place where you don't have a little part of you that believes in magic or the good things.
I believe in good CG and filters.
I don't know.
Sharknado 3.
Sharknado! Gosh. They have worked that set of filters to death. Like, whatever they paid for it, they got their money back out, didn't they?
Yeah, I feel
so. But then I'm a sci-fi... in for Helix and all their shows, and I'm watching Dark Matter now, and just everything. And of course, you know, Defiance, and then it's really all just whatever I'm watching till Game of Thrones comes back is what it is. I watch other TV until Game of Thrones comes back. I don't know about Outlander. Outlander really freaked me out this season. I'm not going to do a spoiler. I'm not going to let John do a spoiler. But dude, I did not read the second book or something.
Yeah, I'm not. Yeah, no.
No spoilers, but ugh. I was like, what is happening here?
You know, we could, you know, a Firefly. You know, there were some Firefly shout-outs in there. So, you know, you could see
a Serenity up there. Leaf on the wind.
Yeah.
Josh Whedon forever!
And someone else pointed out that Halloween's just around the corner, and man, there's going to be like, is this just going to be like a month of blacklight parties? Just like, because there's been a whole bunch of really good suggestions. Like, there's a pumpkins, like Pumpkin Man. Like, we could revisit Pumpkin Man.
Blacklight Party Pumpkin Man.
Yeah. And you know what? I was feeling
A portrait. Less landscape, more portrait.
I was feeling slightly guilty because, you know, I derail your conversation here to be slightly more less intellectual and less. You tend to really be heartfelt and talk about people's journey, and I make fun of you. So it's a little different sometimes.
You know, do not let him fool you. When he sees paintings come up on the Facebook page, he's so touched by that. He's so moved when you guys, you know, are sharing your art and saying this is my first painting, or I mean, you know, it is amazing, and we just appreciate that and we take that very seriously. Yeah, so there's the white and yellow. This is really what you're going to need to do for that. And I'm going to let that dry a little bit. And I'm going to get the basis in for my houses, which I'm going to do with a quarter inch brush. And so I don't know if y'all remember houses in school. I'm going to paint it on the palette cam real quick just to cover it. I don't know if you can flip it, but...
Yeah. No, not from here.
All right. Well, you know, it's going to be like this little triangle shape and then two lines down. And then you'll paint that in. And then I'm going to do a little purple right here. What is all that noise, John? What kid is up?
I'm not sure. But what I have to say, there's a great comment here. And
we're going to do a little roof. I'll just get this in, though.
Yeah.
See, and that's really all it takes to do the houses. It's really, and then we put little windows in. It's pretty simple.
After we get the house, and I'll come back to some of these comments.
Okay. So we got the house in. So that's kind of basically what I'm going to do. Go ahead and give me comments.
Well, I have one here that is... I'm going to have to just take a complete stab at the name. It's an awesome name. It's F Titan? E-F... Oh my, I can't even spell it. F Titan? So, first time painting with us, and wanted to... Brandy.
Hi, Brandy!
And she wanted to say hello. This is her first time painting with us tonight and doing live. And she wanted to thank us for doing this live. And we have... Let's see here. Oh my gosh, they've just scrolled by so fast, everyone.
That is awesome.
Let me go back over here and catch up on the camera as well.
Put this on. I'm going to get some purple. The houses are kind of a messy hotbed, but it's a lot of fun to do.
We should definitely have you pick the canvas up and bring it up to the camera here.
I'm going to get this one in. And I might start doing the black. And sometimes people like to draw the black part first and then color it in. And I think I'm doing it because I'm actually dyslexic, for real. And honestly, sometimes my brain processes information out of order. It just does, which is, you know, was a little tough in school, but I've found as an adult is actually a superpower in other areas.
How long have you been painting?
So, whole life. I was very lucky. My mom was an artist and her mother was an artist. And so those skills were valued in our home. And you got a lot of emotional support for that. So I've been able to do this my entire life. And I feel very lucky because I know that that is not true for everybody. Some people are not supported in their art or treated like that's a good or valid choice. Like, one, everything that we're supposed to do in life is supposed to have some sort of remuneration. Like, it's supposed to be profitable. It couldn't just be good for us emotionally as a thing that we might do. So I'm putting that in, and then I try to get that one a little more in the right thing, and I do the fronts with the blue and the white, and then the sides and the purple. I'll get the steeple on this. This is the church, so I'm gonna grab some white. I lived in France for a little bit with my mother, and I have to say they've got, like, in every village
and
a beautiful old church that's like everywhere.
And for those who are just tuning in or don't know, who is your mom?
My mom is Ginger Cook, and she has a channel, Ginger Cook Live. And you can go. I'm going to do another Van Gogh piece in answer to this one. Some other one. She has a lot of Van Gogh pieces already on her channel. Actually, which could probably count. She's got a lot of his florals.
There we go. Yeah, pull that up there. Looks nice.
You can see how bright the yellow is.
Yeah, it's really bright.
See, it's just a simple house.
And it's really implied.
Yeah, it's an implied house. Whatever you can let someone's brain finish in a painting, they will do better than you could ever paint in. It's an interesting thing. People be weirdly less critical of abstract art than highly realistic art.
So
I'm going to do this one the correct way. I'm going to do it in black first. And then fill in the purple and the blue. Again, dyslexic, so sometimes I do things in unusual order. My brain gives me the information just a little differently. My daughter has ADHD, which we say is a superpower. But the same thing with her. The brain just gives her information slightly differently.
So I'm going to say thank you out there to Touchdown Inflatables, who shared that he said, my mom has had a massive stroke and has had to have brain surgery, and your videos have been the best rehab for her. And what you do really matters, and thank you so much. And I just wanted to say thank you for sharing that, because this is really what we do this for. This is really what drives a lot of what we do. We want to help people with this and try to reach out, and that's great. So thank you for sharing.
And I would like to add, I really want to send light and love and in her recovery and in her process, and say that the science is really in on that, and coloring and painting is incredibly beneficial to strokes and brain injuries. It really is. And so the more that she can do, the more benefit she'll get out of it. And everyone here just wishes her well and a speedy recovery. And I just hope she comes out of this okay. I understand that my mom had a stroke a couple years ago, and it was in her eye, and we thought she was going to lose her vision. And it's just really scary to have something happen to a family member, to somebody you love. And I'm just really glad the art is helping at all. And we just, all of us, will just send her light and love right now and healing.
Yep. Thank you very much for sharing.
Thank you for sharing that.
Now, just to let everyone know that this is on, we are live, or if you're with us here live, this is DVR enabled, so you'll be able to rewind and then catch back up with us if you need to pause and take a bio break. And
bio break. like we're on the Firefly.
Hey, you know. So, but it will also be, the show should be available immediately afterwards, on demand here on YouTube, just like any of our other videos.
Why we like this is because it's going to let us make more videos more often to connect with you guys and really talk to you. And it will help us know what you guys are liking. Like, you guys can be in here like going, hey, I need to see a bee. Somebody help me with bees.
We've had some requests tonight for butterflies, and there's some other ones earlier that I missed.
Yeah,
some foliage, flowers. Margaret does a much better job at tracking the comments. I have to keep one eye on you to make sure that I'm tracking.
Yeah, she's been real quiet, but we have my friend Margaret in the house, and she's gonna be learning from John too. So like if you know something's happening and he can't be here, she's gonna be here, and she's actually in life not quiet at all. Not in the least quiet, and she's just being polite, and she's real funny, so you guys will probably get to know her very well. And I've known her from before my daughter was born.
Yeah.
So she's going to be hoot and half. So I've got those little structures sort of in, and what I've sort of found with this is people put in their own village. They just put in the village that they wish they were visiting, and that's acceptable. We do not need to recreate the historic village. I mean, when they did the Doctor Who episode, they filmed it in Croatia, so.
there is a just wash of comments coming in on animals and requests of roosters and cats and piggies and teddy bears and cats and mermaids and more mermaids. And there was one that was really good. Where is it? Spider-Man riding a tiger. I think Spider-Man riding a tiger is my favorite so far.
I don't know what the demand for Spider-Man riding a tiger is, but that is an artistically compelling suggestion. And I'd like to do that. Like at some point down the road, I'd like to start one of these where, you know, we do a painting challenge, and if there's like a certain amount of, like we give it like 5 minutes on a vote, and if there's a certain request that's really high, that I just figure out how to paint it. Like that's crazy, but I've done that before.
Cinnamon
I've done
this on kind of demand.
Huh?
Cinnamon on demand.
Cinnamon on demand.
Is Cinnamon your real name?
Cinnamon is my
Someone
real name.
Someone asked that. It doesn't seem like it's your real name.
But you married me, so you know it is.
I know it's. I've seen your birth certificate. I know it's your real name.
So you know it is. No, it's my easel name.
It's your easel name.
Light and love to career choices everywhere. They're all valid. But, yeah. My mom and my dad.
This is live.
You're like, it's live, sweetheart. No, I'm going to validate everybody's career choices. I will never get ahead making anyone feel bad. It's just not my thing. It's not what I'm going to do, and no one can ever make me do that. That's not going to happen. Because, I'm in charge of crayons and nothing else. My mom was a real big fan of a show called Mission Impossible. And there was a character on it, I guess, in the 60s with the name Cinnamon, who was a spy. And my mom had not wanted to grow up and be an artist. She'd wanted to grow up and be a spy, but she couldn't figure out how to make that transition. Honestly, having grown up with her, I think she really missed her calling. She would be really good. You can't get information. I don't know. Like, sometimes she's tight-lipped, and sometimes she, like, tells people stuff she shouldn't tell. She's, like, really good. She's, like, she's a double agent is what she is. But I do feel she missed her calling. And so she named me that, and sadly just an artist, not a spy. Because you know what I don't want to be ever is tortured. And also I don't want to mess with other people at all. So I don't think I have the personality type for it.
So you remember that girl who thinks that I can't pronounce her name?
Yeah.
So her nephew Cody.
Maricha?
I'm gonna mispronounce his name too. It's C-O-A-D-Y.
Okay. I'm going to say Cody, too.
Yeah. So he would... But it's his birthday. My nephew Cody wants me to paint for his birthday. And he would love a shout-out.
Hi, Cody. Happy birthday. I hope you have a creative birthday. I hope you have a birthday with family and friends. And I hope it's full of the kind of memories that last with you your entire life. Keep arting. So, like, I wonder how long till somebody, like, actually does a birthday on a live event.
Oh, it's got to have happened already.
The background squeaking is Margaret coming in and out. No, we don't mind at all. We just... Because somebody will be like, what was that?
We'll soon, like, soon we'll have a wide studio camera.
So how I'm getting these windows is these are yellow and white. Again, that yellow and white trick, not to throw away Thomas Kincaid's entire package of secrets, but that's just cad yellow. Medium. That, you know, Bob Ross was using the whole time. Just saying.
Should we
I get an opinion because I actually knew Kincaid.
So. Should we raise our glass to Bob?
To Bob! To Bob and the brush of destiny. Wherever he is, I'm sure he's inspiring art teachers like me everywhere. All right, so I have this little village. This is my village. This thing keeps coming forward. This is my village. Your village may have teeny tiny little houses, or may have bigger houses. It's all villages are acceptable. All villages are valid. All villages are valid. Now, if you're just doing Starry Night, good news is you're about done because all we have to do is the cypress. I'm going to get my half inch angle brush out again. And I'm going to get some just cad. I love my cadmium. Now, a good place to save money, again, is hue. And some of you guys have asked, well, what's the hue? Because I don't see that on my tube. The student brand of paint, like Liquitex Basics, they're always hue. Because cad's a very expensive material. It is should never be eaten.
And you're wetting your brush there.
Yeah, I'm wetting my brush.
You're psyching me out, but what you're actually doing is just getting water there and lowering that down.
Well, what it is the lights have been on the paint. It's getting gummy, and I'm just trying to get some flow into it again.
Okay, so, but...
It wouldn't normally be gummy on me, but, you know, that's what's happening. So now I'm going to come, and I'm going to be putting some orange streaks through here, because I really like... Well, I guess they're really cat red streaks, but we're going to be putting them through... Because I like a little bit of that showing through, and I'm going to get a little yellow. Make sure that that's a little blended. Just having some fun here.
Happy little fire bush.
Right now, it should look like something. Yes, it should look like a fire bush. You know, historically accurate is this black shape, but not to argue with Mr. Van Gogh. I just don't like it. I never enjoyed painting the big black bush. So I just said, you know what, I'm not going to do it. You could just paint that all black if you were just like, no, I really like the black bush. But what people don't realize is, again, he bought paint from pirates. So a lot of times his paint changed color. So people have written entire graduating theses on something that was not the color it was originally at. So they're like, oh, the meaning of the white roses, but they weren't originally white. So... I love the laughing in the background, which inspired me.
They're getting away with something.
So I've mixed this yellow ochre and the blue, and I'm coming up in here. When it mixes into the orange, it will gray out. Little bits of it will show through. But it's really, again, it's about the layers. So this will actually end up being quite a deep bush, but I just I'm a 9-year-old kid, I swear to God. This will be quite a deep bush, but these little bits of yellow will peek out. And then when we do the highlights, it'll be quite profound and lovely. And so, like, right at this stage, it should be sort of this weird, ugly, hot mess, but yet kind of wonderful. I'm going to come here. I may need to put out some yellow so I can make my lighter color. Some slightly lighter colors. So I'll need a scotch yellow. And then after this, if for those of you just doing Starry Night, you're done and you'll be good. But those doing the TARDIS, we still have that, which is going to be a lot of fun to put in. So add a little of the cad to this hot mix.
You know, one of our viewers was noticing that you have a lot of unique glasses. That lemonade glass that was, you're not using it tonight, but did you make the, did you paint that?
No, but we're going to make some glasses at some point here on Heart Party on one of our projects. We're going to make some glasses. The glasses are either from Cracker Barrel or...
Pier 1?
Pier 1, yeah.
Yeah.
Mama loves a Cracker Barrel.
I do.
Spider loves Cracker Barrel.
Dude, it's good. I like me some Cracker Barrel. So I've got this saged out color, and I'm going to come and bring this up in these long little strokes.
I think Jules said hello.
Jules?
Yeah, I'm scrolling back
like
up here.
Margaret's Jules?
Yeah. I think he's up watching. I'm not sure he's supposed to be up this late.
Was it Jules? Jules! Jules is a really good artist. Everybody, wherever you're at, sitting, wave at Jules. Jules is a very good artist. Actually, all of Margaret's children are very good artists. They're all creative because their mom is a really good artist. Actually, my mom, Ginger, if you know her, constantly is begging me about that Margaret doesn't paint enough. And that she was so talented and she should continue painting. Just to completely out Margaret to a bunch of strangers. She wants some paints. I mean, I seriously do get grief from my mom every time I see her about the fact that you're not painting enough.
So, do you know who Amy Ringholt is?
I feel like I do.
She's an artist. One of the community was asking us if we knew who she was and if we would do a painting inspired by her. So I was like, you know, I would. Like be the last.
Like if she's not litigious and crazy, sure.
So we'll put a pin in.
I'll do a painting inspired by anybody that won't sue the crud out of me.
And do you ever paint with watercolors?
Yes.
We don't see a lot of that though.
No, I it's something like if people would like to do it, I'm good at it. We could do it.
You did some at Downtown Disney. We played around with it there.
Yeah, so. I brought my watercolors. I think I was supposed to just bring pens.
That's all right.
But I brought my watercolors. But I got to paint with Stev Ray Bro,
yeah,
Animation Channel,
awesome.
Will Terrell, and of course the very sweet and endearing Valerie, who's a fantastic artist.
Yep.
Best draw of my life on YouTube. Not kidding. Best draw of my life. Best. By like far.
There's already Mod Podge questions.
Oh, about, I have Mod Podge answers. Don't.
About paint. I know. It's like we're going to have to bring the Mod Podge themes back.
Okay, so
back.
What it is Mod Podge is a fabulous tool. Do not finish your paintings with it.
Oh, no. This was in regards to painting on wine glasses.
Oh, yeah. Then that's fine.
there's some definite feelings about Mod Podge up in the Sherpa's neighborhood.
Well, it's just what it is. It's a fabulous sealant. It's fabulous for decoupage. They have like 20 types of Mod Podge, and it's a really good tool. But much like resin, will yellow very quickly, and therefore is a problem. Unless I'm getting some letter from the Mod Podge people tomorrow, like, we fixed that formula. Don't speak about us.
Then we'll be like, sorry.
So I've done some very light yellow-green here to do some highlights into my...
Can you bring this up closer? Because I think that we're really probably not catching the how really painterly that fire bush is. And yeah, you can bring it right up there to the camera and it catches it. Yeah, it's got it right there. And you can see how the brush stroke, how each stroke of the brush has a lot of different colors of paint on it.
Yeah,
that's
it's
really
like
good.
Like really get in there. Now I'm like having fun.
Now you're just seeing if yeah, I've got that camera's a good camera. It'll take.
That's
it.
A really good camera.
All right, so that's good.
But I mean, you know, if you're looking at that and you're like, "Hey, what's going on with this?" and I feel like I've lost a lot of my dark color, so I want to put it back. And you may have to do that. You may be just like, "Oh my God, I lost all my darks, and I want to put them back." And you just take a little yellow and blue and make a dark green, and then you can come right back and
start
put that
keeping
back.
Score on you.
Huh?
Start keeping score on you.
Are we keeping score?
Yeah.
Don't do it.
If you don't start, you know, keep going back to that palette without picking up paint.
When do I do that? I don't even feel like I do that as much as you think I do that. But maybe I do.
I'll get like the sports graphic package so I can start putting score up there.
Oh, arts will save broadcasting.
Shh.
Sorry. Was that a secret?
Network television.
Someone from network television. Don't tell anyone. You weren't supposed to tell anyone.
It's a secret.
It's a secret. So here's my little bush. And that's how I did that. And then you saw it up close. And now, so what I'll say to this, for those of you who that just came to enjoy Vincent van Gogh's Starry Night, your heart is where your art is. Vincent said, if you ever want to know if you can paint, just paint. And he's completely right. All of this is just a set of skills. So if you're first painting in, all you have to do is finish. And then do the second painting and the next painting, and it'll come. It comes for everybody. I've seen it again and again. Brushstroke is the fingerprint of your soul, and your brushstroke should not look like other people's. You do need to learn things like dry brushing and wet into wet and all those different skills. But the whole point is your art won't look like anyone else's art, which is why we can look at art and go, oh, I know who did that. That's Van Gogh. I'm going to put in the TARDIS now. Because in this story, the Time Lord and Amy Pond have just come to deal with why there was a face in Vincent van Gogh's church painting, and only he can see this invisible monster, which actually they took a bunch of criticism for. I don't know, how did you feel about that monster?
Which one?
I can't say it, the invisible monster that was on that episode.
Oh.
I don't know, they took it really seriously. They actually took the episode very seriously. There was a lot of thought put into that.
Yeah.
And so he had this, like, he was the only one who could see it, and he was kind of in love with Amy Pond. It was a whole interesting thing, and I love when they took him forward in time and showed him his work that he was so loved. I think it's going to make me tear up. That he was so loved.
Oh, yeah.
So beautiful. Loved it so much. Loved the doctor. Very much enjoyed David Tennant. Was that, I don't know, everyone, what's your favorite doctor? Oh, mine was David Tennant.
Yes, that was asked earlier, and I neglected to actually ask the question because we were in the middle of a lot of things. And sorry, I don't get to all the questions all right away.
So I'm going to put out some phthalo blue for my police box. I'm going to put out some dogs in purple. If you want to pull up on your smartphones and your devices or print out a police box, a TARDIS to look at, artists paint what they're looking at better. I'm going to do this very abstract, though, because I want it to fit into the painting.
Sorry, what is it you're trying to fit into the painting?
Well, I'm not going to do this very tight. I'm not going to do this very architectural because I want it to look like it's part of this painting, like Van Gogh was looking outside the asylum and saw the... that's a good scream if you heard it. I don't know. Could you pick that up, John?
What? No, I did not.
Okay. I never know what anyone can hear, but that spider's happy. And if you really want to darken the color, you can grab a little cad red to just really darken it. So I'm going to draw my little square, and it's just going to start out. I want it to break up these shapes here. Oh, you know what? I forgot to put in the moon.
It's all right.
So guess what, Starry Night people? I hope you didn't leave because you're not totally done. But we're committed to at least the basic square of our box. And I'm doing this at an angle, and I'm just drawing a rectangle. Just a loose rectangle. Couple inches, 2.5 inches wide or so. And I'm not measuring it out. I'm not taping it out. The basis of the TARDIS really is in this rectangle. Probably should have a whole separate little short mini video, how to loosely paint the TARDIS. Just that. I wonder how many people are just gonna go to the end of the video and how to paint the TARDIS. Just the TARDIS, I don't need the whole rest of that painting. Just gotta paint some TARDIS on these shoes. So yes, I do the purple and blue to make the very deep base. And then as soon as I have this in, we'll just quick put the moon in for anyone who wants it. Well, I actually think the painting looks really good where it is. Don't use your blue brush, though. Get another small brush. I'm looking for another. Oh, there's another small brush. And I'm going to get my orange. I'm going to get a little yellow, whatever I have left in my yellow. And it's just the letter C if you want it.
There.
Because that was in the original painting, so it's the letter C. Don't get mental about it. You guys always get mental about it. It's not that big a deal. It's just the letter C. It's not an architecturally correct moon. It's not how we'd paint the moon if we were just trying to paint the moon.
A little sippy-sippy there.
Sippy-sippy. Oh my god, I'm so like... See, this is why we need the after party, because I have a whole bottle finish off. I don't actually... It's like I have to go get it. I wonder what the favorite doctor ended up being. I don't know. What is she doing? Oh, fabric, paper, and beads. Brenda, thank you for coming. I hope you get to share your channel. You know, if you guys need to come back later and just put them in the comments once the video's up, again, I'll approve them. Because we're a community. We're a family of art YouTubers. United in the common goal of sharing creativity across YouTube. Where did John go? It's weird to see myself over there on delay. Go count children. All right. Are we back?
We're back.
All right. Brenda had to go. Did anyone get to put their channels up? Or
there were a lot. I have to unlock the ability for people to
So here's what they can do. After the broadcast is over, if they want to, they can put them up in the permanent comments. And I'll approve them later.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm using a bright quarter-inch brush. And I'm using this because it makes this next job easier. Just a scotch past my TARDIS. I just make a straight stroke, or as straight as I can. And see, I'm gonna get it up close and show you when I'm done, because you're gonna think that I made like this incredibly straight stroke, and then you're gonna be like, I don't, and then I'm gonna show it to you and you'll be like, oh no, hers is a hot mess too, and I'm gonna be like, yep. And by the way, just so you're clear, the original meaning of hot mess is something that is like crazy, but still beautiful. See, not perfect. Not perfect.
Looks great from here.
But still happy and still just wonderful. And then above this, coming in, about the same size as the original box, is another little square. It's really actually quite fun and easy to do. And then another one above that that's a little bit smaller. And then, of course, what would be the light? But you're going to actually weirdly do... I don't know how to get it where it's not... See, when it's wet, it's super glary because the lights...
So move it to your right a little bit more. And down and more to the right. Oh, there you go.
Where, here?
Somewhere in there. Anywhere in there. There, tilt it.
All right. That's so pretty, see, it's just that's basic.
That's pretty good there.
And I think Chuck is working on something for this so that we have some sort of traceable, drawable, something easy.
Chuck is always doing something awesome.
Yeah, Chuck is always doing something awesome. Go there. By and check out Chuck's channel, The Animated Pencil. See what he is up to. It's very cool.
Some Chuck graphic there.
Chuck Carson. So I'm going to come in here, and now I'm going to have my little turquoise pulled out here so I have it where I can get to it. And I'm going to have just white, and I'm going to weirdly just start sketching things in very, very loosely. And you're going to see me looking over here because I'm going to be like, what? So the first thing I need to have are the two window boxes that are right here. And I'm going to do these first ones in like this lighter color paint, but I'm going to come in and do them even lighter later. I'm just sort of getting them in right now. My friend Margaret can do this in cake. I could be eating this after if she was making this. And just about as well as I do it, she can just do it in frosting. I'm going to make a slightly darker. Come down here between these two. I'm just trying to create a definition. And then And I'm going to hold this up to the camera so you can see this. It's really loose. We're keeping this very, very loose. Slight minor tonal differences. It's crazy when it all pulls together. It will trip you out. You'll be like, what? How did that even work? Four little squares here. That's a little lighter than I want. I'm going to get a little darker blue going. Four little squares in here. All right, so that would be that little inset. I don't know. What is the woodworking term of that, John, when it's like all inset?
Recessed?
Recessed, inset? Thank you. That's not a woodworking term. That's just a word. But it's the correct one, and I didn't think of it, so John wins.
yay.
A game he did not even know he was entered
in. I love those games. The games that I win that I didn't know I was playing.
Yeah. John wins a lot of those games where he announced, you have won. He's like, I didn't even know I was playing.
Woohoo!
So here we go. And see, it's just crazy how it instantly, like, oh, wait, that's starting to take shape. And yet nothing is going on there at all. And then I'm going to just pull some. Notice how I'm not even rinsing my brush. I'm just grabbing some paint. I'm going to come here very lightly. Outline. But not completely. Here's the trick. I am not in any way finished these outlines. See, this has got to be painterly. In other words, the artist's fancy word for hot mess. This has got to be painterly the whole way through. Otherwise, it will really stand out from the background. So I'm coming and I'm doing the upper right corner and maybe outlining that a little bit. I'm just very loosely outlining this. Adding these little highlights. I haven't rinsed out my brush, so it's not a pure white, and it's picking up color underneath. It's picking up the color around it. Defining those little squares. I'm going to get a little more white because I want these windows to be more white than they are. But not totally white. Not totally white.
Do we have any idea what we're going to paint tomorrow?
So we have some options, and I've got two trees. I've got the rainbow tree and then the bohemian tree.
Oh, sorry about that.
What was it?
I had it sitting on the palette cam there for a minute.
You had it sitting on the palette cam?
So do you think that you'd want to take a poll on who, on what video we would like to see tomorrow?
I mean, we can. We could take a request, and then I could just design it and paint it. We could see how that worked. That'd be a nice shot off the bow to doing paintings on demand.
I just looked over, and Shelly Rice wanted us to say hello to Cinnamon.
Hi, Shelly. Thank you. Okay, so are we getting a lot of requests in?
I'm scrolling over there. Yeah. I'm looking over there to see if I can see what's going on. As it's just coming up.
Kind of a little turquoise there. I'm going to come down here and put that little turquoise there.
So, Secret says that we should not poll, though.
I don't blame her. I bet she never wants to poll again. See, we're building that up. But it's when you see it up close, it's what I'm not painting in. I'm letting your, because dude, if I do this very tight, if I do this very considered, what'll happen is your brain won't like it. In the loose painting, it will feel very incongruent.
So I think the Bohemian tree is winning so far. There's a lot of.
Oh, cool. I wanted to do that. Bohemian tree. I mean, it's on Pinterest. And it's done very, very well. People like the Bohemian tree. And it's about time we do another tree.
Yeah, it's just like that's like everyone is pretty much saying, tree please.
Oh yeah, happy to do Bohemian tree. Now we're gonna come up here and we're gonna take a little of whatever little yellow. Oh wait, that's just gone green. I'm gonna have to put out a little yellow. I'm gonna This is my Liquitex. Oh, by the way, Liquitex. The best if you have hand or grip issues. Of all the paints, by far. Best design caps on the market. All right, I'm going to get some yellow, just yellow. And I'm going to come in here and make this little lamp in here. Wipe my brush off. Add a little cad red. Just in the center. Now, we're almost winding to the end of this, too. But we've got to put some crossbars in the windows of dark color. All right. We want that dark color. Bohemian tree it is tomorrow. See, it's just very relaxed.
It looks pretty good.
Yeah, well, it looks great here, but just it's important to see how loose it is up close. And your eye, as soon as it gets any distance, your eye's like, I finish it. I know what you meant. I'll fix it for you. Like, I wrote police call box so bad the first time. People can still read it. I'm going to try again. Now, I'm resting my wrist on what is my dry canvas. And that helps me letter. I'm using a very nice detail brush. And I'll do a twist and I'll just load the tip. I don't know if you can see that, but the tip is... It's not going to focus.
No, it's easier.
Not going to do it. But the tip is just loaded.
You know, unfortunately, there's been a lot of requests for the Bohemian tree, and even some requests to see the image, but I don't have that loaded up here, so sorry.
Yeah, so that is on Pinterest, in the Heart Party board, towards the bottom. It is, so there's the tree with drips, and then right next to it is the one with all the dots. And it's like this kind of crazy tree, and it's got all these weird kind of like bohemian-y little dots. So go by and make sure you like that, because it's what we're painting tomorrow. Unless you're like, oh wait, no, I thought it was something else. And you should know it's like kind of reds and golds and blues and stuff like that. It does look like a bohemian little tree. That's what it looks like.
So I have to say thanks to Margaret. She's been a real trooper hanging in here.
She really has. She's like a life and a family and stuff.
Yeah.
And you guys have been great hanging in.
Yes,
they're pretty awesome hanging in. So I'm getting this sort of like orange color. And the reason is that I want to create a radiating set of lines around this. And that's going to represent the sound and the fact that this is transitioning through temporal shifts. That's probably how Van Gogh would have painted it. Seeing it come in is very loose. And he would have had things radiating around it as well.
So I was just looking up there, and it looks like you and the Secret was saying that the two of you are conspiring on a collaboration here.
Yes. Actually, it's a massive one, isn't it? She's talking about the big, big, big one.
I'm the person you should ask that of.
Monday, check my channel, check Secret's channel, not to like... Auntie Bernie's channel, the Junkin' Data Girls channel, and probably at some point right after that Clive's and stuff, because something big is coming around the bend again. So I'm not allowed to, there's a date to release and like even start talking about it, but stuff is happening that is awesome.
We've already told you too much.
We've already said too much, and I'm going to get...
Take you out and torture you to find out more information.
So I've got a little white there to add to the radiating feeling. And I'm going to do right around this light because it was so dark in the reds and stuff that I want to make sure that this feels like light from that lamp. All right, so see up close though, craziness out here weirdly feels like police box in a starry night. Woo! Did it! Woohoo! So. Happy, happy, happy. Secret dance. We have finally done on YouTube. Finally on YouTube is a Starry Night. And it just, of course, because it's YouTube, has to have a Doctor Who twist. Got to. So, we'll post on our YouTube channel and then Facebook what we're going to be doing next. Be sure to be watching Ginger Cook Live for her answer. Like, how could she even answer this? What could she even do to be as awesome as this? I don't know. Where you want to Van Gogh? Where you want to Van Gogh? I want to see you guys soon. To everybody who came, thank you. To everybody who commented, thank you. Thank you, my husband. Thank you to Margaret. Thank you to my Sippy Sippy.
Sippy Sippy.
I'm going to see you guys at the easel again really soon. Bye-bye.